nothing but the blood of Jesus. Nothing but the blood. See your presence, oh, presence. Nothing but the blood. Can the sight see for me? There is power, the sight, power. Can you sing it a bit louder? Sing it louder. Oh, oh yes. In the my left inside there is. Wonder working. Everybody sing. There is power. Oh, there is power. Wonder working. Of the land. There is wonder working power. In the precious blood of the, let's shout out to God, because there is power. Do you guys believe it? Here tonight there is power. Oh, Lord, send your power. 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 Come on, Lord. Send your power, send your power, Lord. Send your power. Send your power, Lord. Send your power, Lord. Send your power. Send your power, Lord. Send your power. I'm so excited here tonight. You know, I'm going to mess it up here, Pastor, because I'm so excited for God. Say hallelujah. Chosen, we are a chosen generation. So is excellent. All I require for life, God has given me. I know. Sing it again. We are a chosen generation. So is excellent. All I require. All I require for life, God has given me. I know who say I am, what He says I am, where He says I am. God says I am, where. Oh yes. Come on, sing now together. We walking in power. Hallelujah. I'm walking in power, walking in miracles. I live a life of favor. I know who I am. I'm walking in power. I know who I am. And I am holy. I am righteous. I'm walking in power. Come on, sing. I'm walking in power, walking in miracles. Oh, I live a life of favor. I know. I'm walking in miracles. I live a life of favor. I know. I wonder if I can go to Africa, but in my, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, I know who I am. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, 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 oh. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I know who I am. Yeah. Oh, 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 oh. I know who. Let's give God praise. Give Him praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Our hands up to the heavens. Let's focus on God tonight. Close your eyes. Focus on God. Because the atmosphere is changing now. Oh. Worship the King. Worship. The atmosphere is changing now. For the Spirit of the Lord is here. Evidence is all around. Spirit of the Lord is here. The atmosphere is changing now. For the Spirit of the Lord is here. Evidence is all around. The Spirit of the Lord is overflowing this place. Fill our hearts with your love, your love. Surround us. You're the reason we came to encounter your love. Your love surrounds us. Sing it again. Overflow. overflowing this place. Fill our hearts with your love, your love. Surround us. You're the reason. You're the reason we came to encounter your love, your love. Surround us.
Oh,
the atmosphere. The Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all around. The Spirit of the Lord is here. The atmosphere is changing now.
Can you feel the atmosphere is changing?
For the Spirit of
God is here.
The evidence is all around that the Spirit of the Lord is overflowing this place. Fill our hearts with your love. Your love surrounds us. You're the reason we came to encounter your love surrounds us.
Sing it again, overflow,
overflow in this place. Fill our hearts with your love. Your love surrounds us. You're the reason we came to encounter your love. Your love surrounds
us. Oh, His love surrounds us. Spirit of God is here. Fall fresh on us. We need your presence, God. Need your presence. Oh, we need your presence. Oh, we need your presence. We need your presence. Oh, heaven come down, bring heaven down in this place. Spirit of God, fall fresh on us. We need your presence. Your kingdom come, your will be done, yes, in heaven.
Come and jump on this boat. Spirit of God, fall fresh on us. We need your presence,
your kingdom,
your kingdom come. Your will be done.
Your presence, your kingdom.
we need.
Your kingdom
come, your will be done.
In heaven, Spirit of God,
Spirit of God,
for fresh
on us,
we need
your presence.
Oh God, we need your presence.
Your kingdom come,
your will
be done
here as
in heaven.
Come on, the atmosphere.
The atmosphere changing now.
Declare it.
For the Spirit of the Lord is here.
Evidence
is all around
that the Spirit of the Lord is here.
Sing it again.
Miracle.
The atmosphere is changing now. For the Spirit of the Lord
is here.
Whisper.
The evidence,
it's all around, it's all around.
That the Spirit,
that the Spirit of is here.
Oh, Spirit,
Spirit.
The atmosphere is
changing now.
For the Spirit,
for the Spirit
of the Lord
is here.
Evidence.
The evidence is all around.
The Spirit of the Lord is here.
Oh.
Spirit of God.
Spirit of God.
For fresh
on us,
we need.
Your kingdom come,
your will be done here as in heaven.
Come on, Spirit of God,
Spirit
of God,
for fresh
on us,
we need
your presence.
Your kingdom come.
Kingdom come,
your will be done,
your will be done
here as in heaven.
Spirit of God, fall fresh on us,
we need your presence.
Your kingdom come,
your will be done
here as
in heaven.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
Spirit of God,
fall fresh on us,
fall fresh on us.
Oh, heaven's rain, we need your power,
we need your life,
we need your anointing in this hour.
Oh, resurrection power,
presence of the living God,
here as
in heaven.
Because the atmosphere is changing. Because the atmosphere is changing.
Changing.
Come on.
home as we worship together in spirit and in truth. The atmosphere is changing. Oh, as we lift up holy hands, we glorify the Lord as we welcome Him tonight. The atmosphere is changing. The Spirit of the Lord is here. Lives have been touched. Miracles can happen as we praise Him. Spirit of God, fall fresh on us. We need Your presence, Your kingdom come, Your will be done, here as in heaven. Come on, people. Oh, Spirit of God,
Spirit of God,
fall fresh
on us. We need Your presence.
Your kingdom come.
Your kingdom come. Your will be done in heaven.
And the atmosphere is changing.
The atmosphere
is changing. Changing now, for the Spirit of the Lord is here, and I see the evidence all around.
The evidence is all around
that the Spirit of the Lord,
Spirit of the Lord,
come on, say it again. The atmosphere is changing.
Changing
in my life.
For the
Spirit of the Lord is here. And
the evidence is all around.
And the Spirit of the Lord is here.
And the Spirit of the Lord is here.
Come on, just take it right now.
There
it is right now. Father, we thank You for this night. Come on, lift up your hands, everybody. Come on, just to cry out to the Lord where you are. Just call out to the Lord right now where you are. We cannot do anything outside of the life of God, the presence of God, the Spirit of God. If you're in a dry and a thirsty land, if you feel like you're in a desert, there's water for your soul. There's life-giving waters here tonight. If you're listening, there's life-giving waters where you are. Maybe just work and life has just worn you out, but there's life here tonight. There's power here to heal your body, to restore your soul, to bring your joy back again, to bring your hope back again, to give you a new vision, for you to begin to see the future, for you to begin to see with the eyes of faith, your understanding being enlightened, the height and the depth and the breadth of God. As you're lifting up your hands, God's going to open up your eyes to see, your ears to hear, your heart to know. The glory of the King is in our midst, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Somebody say, thank you, Lord, for greater things that are yet to come. In Jesus' name. Somebody say, the Spirit of the Lord is here. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's freedom and liberty. Thank you for freedom and liberty in our midst. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Isn't that awesome? How many feel like things are shifting? You know, my dad always used to say, we used to sit and pray in our home for many hours and hours and hours.
And my dad always used to say one thing since a child. He used to say, pray till you get a release or till you feel the peace of God. How many sense the peace of God, the presence of God? Isn't that awesome to be in the presence of God? I want to just turn in my Bible right now to the book of John. If you would turn there, I want to talk about resurrection. I don't know how far I'm going to get because, you know, the Lord is moving the way he wants to move. But I want to speak about resurrection. Somebody say resurrection. Somebody say there's glory in resurrection. But there's also glory when you're going through death. There's glory. God shows us glory. John 11. It's a whole story. I'm just going to read John chapter 11, verse 4. And it says, when Jesus heard, talking about Lazarus, it says there, Lazarus was sick in verse 2. The sister sent unto him, saying, Lord, behold, whom you love, in verse 3, is sick. Verse 4 says, the sickness, Jesus said, the sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God. Somebody say, the sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God. Somebody say it again, the sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God. I want you to say it again, this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God. I want you to say it again. Say, this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God. I want you to say it again. This sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God. I don't know what sickness or what malady or what condition or what depression or whatever you're going through, but it said that the Son of God might be glorified thereby. Somebody said, the Son of God might be glorified. There's a glory coming. Somebody said, there's a glory coming. Somebody said again, there's a glory coming. I want to go to the book of Ezekiel 37. I'm going to read something to you tonight. If you can go there to the book of Ezekiel 37. I'm just tapping into some stuff just for us this evening, and that the Holy Spirit has been speaking to me about the past couple days. Ezekiel 37, the hand of the Lord was upon me, and he carried me out in the Spirit of the Lord and set me down in the midst of a valley which was full of bones. Somebody said bones and dry bones. Now, we know the whole story of dry bones, but I want to go to verse 12. Verse 12 says, therefore prophesy and say unto them, thus says the Lord, behold, O my people, I will open your graves and cause you to come up out of your graves. Somebody say this, an opening. Somebody say, there's a way. Somebody say, the way maker has gone before me, and he's made a way. How many, a couple hundred or 600-700 years beforehand, the word of God already began to make a way for Jesus and made a way for Lazarus and made a way for us. Oh, glory. Give him glory right now. He said, behold, O my people, I will open your graves and cause you to come up out of your graves and bring you into your land, and you shall know that I am the Lord when I have opened your graves. Oh, man. O my people, and brought you up out of your graves. I tell you, that'll preach for like 10 weeks. Oh, man. I want you to go to the book of Isaiah now. We're going to just go there real quick. Isaiah chapter number 11. Isaiah, if you would turn to Isaiah chapter 11. And Isaiah 11, verse 11. I'm just turning in my Bible. And it says, and it shall come to pass in that day. Isaiah 11, 11. There's the 11, 11. In that day the Lord shall again lift up his hand a second time to recover and deliver the remnant. Somebody say, the remnant of his people. So he said, I'm going to recover the remnant. Somebody say, the remnant shall be recovered. I want you to go now to the book of Romans quickly. Acts, and then we go to the book of Romans. Romans chapter number 9. Acts, and then we get Romans. Chapter number 9, and in chapter number 9, it says something very powerful there in chapter number 9, verse 27, Isaiah, the prophet of God, called out or solemnly cried out, though the number of the sons of Israel be like the sand of the sea, only the remnant, a small part of them, will be saved. For the Lord will execute a sentence upon the earth and close his account with men completely without delay, rigorously cutting it short in his justice. And verse 29 said, it is as Isaiah predicted, if the Lord of hosts had not left us a seed. Somebody say a seed. Oh, glory. A seed, the Bible said, if the Lord had not left us a seed, we had been as Sodom and been made like Gomorrah. Oh, man, that's powerful. If the Lord had not left us a remnant or a seed in every generation, let me just pray. Father, I thank you for your word tonight. I speak the anointing of the 5 loaves and 2 fish, Lord, because I'm just your servant. You speak through me. I don't have the words to say. You have the words to say. You speak to your body. You speak to your church. Words of life, words of hope, words of healing, words of direction, authoritative words, disciplinary words, and encouraging words in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. We see something that God purposed. We see man and we see seeds. Man, God said, I've left me a seed. I've left me a seed, and his name is Jesus. He's the Word of God, became flesh. But he said, in every generation, I've left me a seed. I've left a generation that will honor me. In this generation, we're seeing a spirit that is wanting to take over the world. It's a spirit which the Bible just calls the spirit of corruption. It's corruption. The world is in a place of corruption. Even though they're trying to go for peace, they're trying to go for peace. I mean, a lot of people put their faith in a president of the United States, and I believe, you know, he wants to fight for godly rights and religious rights, but yet still, in the midst of it, just like God said to me when he came, became president, I said it to you, all of you guys, the Lord said to me that there's going to be war. And we can see what's going on in North Korea right now. We can see what's going on in Syria right now. I just got one word. I just said, Lord, what about President Trump? I thank God that he's fighting for Christian rights for the church in America right now. And then I just heard one word, war. So we can see, even in a man, our hope cannot be in a man. Our hope must be in Jesus Christ, folks. It's not in a president or in a government, because we're not part of this world. We represent a kingdom of righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. And that kingdom has an everlasting peace, and it's Christ in us, the hope of glory. And he is our peace, and he is our life. And out of every generation, we see a remnant. We had Martin Luther that was raised up. He had his faults, but he was a remnant that God raised up. We had John Knox that was raised up. We had revivalists that came to South Africa. We had John Alexander Dowie, and we had John G. Lake, and we had men of God in the 50s in America. In every generation, there is a seed. Somebody says seed. That God raises up that have the fullness of the measure of the stature of Christ within them, which are a branch like David. They're a branch like David. Come on, somebody. Out of the dry ground, they'll begin to grow. A branch, somebody say, the root of Jesse. We see the spirit of Saul that is persecuting, and we see the Davids that are hiding in the caves. I found the caves to be quite enjoyable. I found the deserts to be quite enjoyable because they're safe. But there's a time, folks, where God's going to say, you've done your time. You served your time. But I'm dealing with Saul, and I'm going to bring in my anointed ones. I'm going to bring in my branch. The fleshly carnal system must die. Oh, glory to God. We begin to see this whole tapestry of God. How many know he knows how to work things out? Just what God said to me, all things work together for the good of those that love him. If you love him, he'll work it out. If you love him, he'll sort it out. If you love him, even in the mess you've made, he'll work it out. Come on, for your good. It's all for your good. Whether it's bad, whether it's a mess, whether it's a disaster, it's all for your good. Somebody say, it's for my good. God will work it out for your good because he loves you. Come on, you're his child. But in a seed of a mess, we look at the mess. God says, I'm going to turn it around and I'm going to turn it into a great message for my glory. We look at the disaster. We look at the problem. We look at the economic chaos. Instead, we should be looking differently. Come on, somebody. We got to look to Jesus. Amen. There's a finished work that God is establishing, I believe, on this resurrection day. Somebody say resurrection. I see something played out here. We see a spirit that perturbs and bothers many folks because it's impossible looking at it naturally. Graves, death, destruction, misery, corruption, dry bones, all of that mess which the flesh makes. Come on, two seeds, the tree of life and the tree of knowledge of good and evil. I'm in the tree of life, folks. Again, I want to say that out of every generation, there's a remnant God raises up. And I believe we're going to see a remnant that begins to stand up like never before, uncorrupted by the spirit of this world, uncorrupted by the carnality in this world, that love the Lord their God, that are filled with his presence, that are seeking the face of God. Come on, somebody. I believe we're coming into that season. There was Jesus, and Jesus was going on his way, merry journey in John chapter 10. We were in John chapter 11. There's Lazarus. Lazarus is in a bad place. In John chapter 10, we begin to read how Jesus actually just declared they sought to take him, and he went forth out of their hand. John 10:39, Jesus had just left that place because they wanted to stone him, just like they stoned Stephen. They wanted to stone Stephen. They wanted to stone Jesus. Let me say, the worst spirit is not a worldly spirit. It's a religious spirit. It's the religious demon of our day. The religious spirit is the spirit of the Antichrist. It goes to church. It says hallelujah. It shouts amen. It says praise God. But it's all on the flesh. It's all old nature. And it's all carnality. Come on, somebody. But God said, just like Saul, I'm going to deal with Saul because he's on death row. And I'm going to raise in the midst of my people a seed. And there was Jesus going merrily on his way because he escaped a stoning. He escaped something that was really bad because they hated Jesus. If you have Jesus in you, my friend, my brother, my sister, we all say, Lord, send the revival. Lord, send the fire. Lord, we want to see your kingdom come. Lord, fill the earth with your glory. We say all of these things, but let me say this. In true revival, the religious system will hate you. Your friends and family will hate you. But in true revival, you'll experience the presence and power of God. And I believe we're coming to true revival. On this resurrection day, oh hallelujah, we're in a year 5777. Seven is the sword. God is dividing in this hour. God is cutting off the fleshly system in this hour. Come on, how many can see things are shifting in the spirit? So Jesus escaped the Pharisaical, legalistic, judgmental, critical spirit that is in the hearts of men. In today's world, they don't throw stones at you, but they throw words at you. They criticize you. They judge you. They analyze you. They scrutinize you. They pull you to pieces. Man, they get familiar with you. They all knew Jesus. They were all familiar with Jesus. That's why many times I've seen when folks can sit around the anointing, but if they get close to the anointed man of God or men of God or women of God, they don't know how to honor that, and God will chuck them out as soon as they get around it, because the moment there's dishonor, the miracles and the power of God cannot move, and God says, I got to cut them out. There's an inner court, there's an outer court, and there's a holy of holies. Some folks just cannot get into your holy of holies.
It was Peter, James, and John that could get into the Holy of Holies and experience the glory, but not everybody else could be there because they could not cover. You've got to be able to cover the anointing if you get around the anointing and the anointed men of God. Amen. God doesn't come in some airy fairy. He comes with broken vessels. Hallelujah. And the job as a church is to protect. Too many people want to get around it because of what they can get out of it. And when they see the faults of it, they want to judge it and criticize it and throw stones at it. And that's what they did with Jesus.
Religious, judgmental, pharisaical, critical, analytical. And the Bible said the Jews took up stones again to stone him. The Jews answered him, "For a good work we stone thee not, but for blasphemy." John 30 and 31, 10, 30 and 31, we see they began to stand up against him, and it was a spirit. Now let me tell you something. It's the spirit of the old. Many times, even amongst us here, we got to watch in our own hearts. We can have the old with the new, but you cannot have new wine in old wineskins. New wine will cause the old wineskins to burst. We got to have our wineskins dealt with. That's the problem. So if the full revival comes, we're just going to have a problem. So God is allowing many of us to go through some stuff, some graves, some situations. Are you with me tonight? So they wanted to stone him like they did Stephen. How many know what they did to Stephen? Stephen, they ripped him to shreds. Because that same spirit that came against Jesus in Stephen. Amen. And so we see Mark, we see the scripture in John chapter 11, and I'm going to just say this, between John chapter 10 and John chapter 11, there is absolutely no difference. It's just that they added chapters thereafter. There were no chapters and verses, but there is now, and basically we begin to see it moved from chapter 10 all the way through to chapter 11 about the raising, the death and the raising of Lazarus, and we begin to see something here. But in the midst of it all, we see a dying, and it's a great story that God had arranged. He arranged that, and I'm going to just state this, God arranged in his wisdom to do a prophetic demonstration. And I believe we're in the midst of some things now where God is busy doing a demonstration. Like, I call it the Lazarus generation. There's been a lot of death all around. He arranged that Lazarus should die. He arranged that Lazarus should die, and Jesus was not going to interfere. This is where a lot of us get upset. In the name of Jesus, I bind that spirit. But Dachias. And in the name of Jesus. Amen. And we pray and we rebuke and we scream and we shout. We do what we do. But you cannot change the sovereignty of God. You cannot change the intent of God. Amen. For all things work together for the good. Somebody say, for the good of those that love him. And those that are called of his name. So no matter what you're going through, there are some situations that you don't have a prayer to get you out of it. You don't have an individual that can get you out of it. Some situations, you just got to go through it. Some situations, some experiences, some problems, some failures, some weaknesses, some, you know, things, dilemmas that are in your life. God is still in control. God is still the Alpha and the Omega.
God is still the beginning and the end of that situation, and he's got it worked out, and he's going to turn it for your good. And I'm going to say something. Some things have to happen. Sometimes it has to happen. Sometimes, come on, it has to happen because it's for your good. And if it didn't happen, you wouldn't learn the lesson you had to learn. Sometimes the thing you're going through is not really about you. The thing that happened to Lazarus had nothing to do with Lazarus. Come on. Sometimes it has to happen, but God's using your life. Oh, he's using your life. My spiritual father always used to say, everybody wants these mighty anointings and callings, but I don't see many people crying out for an anointing like Lazarus. The one William Branham and Jack Coe and A.A.L. I see weird stuff in the world today. People are going to grave sites of anointed men and they're like praying over the grave sites. I'm like, I don't need to go to a grave site. I have Jesus in me. And I have the same spirit that's in Jesus in me. Praise God. Somebody said God has a plan. Now, God's plan sometimes is a weird plan because this plan was that Lazarus had to die. Ooh. Somebody said, ach, sisman. So sometimes you got a sickness and that sickness has no cure. But God can raise the dead. God can raise the dead. Somebody say, can raise the dead. Nothing was preventing Lazarus from dying. In fact, he was 4 days in that situation. 4 days, if you understand Jewish terminology and Jewish understandings, in the Jewish understandings, it is that after 3 days, the spirit departs. So on the fourth day, your spirit is gone. They believe the spirit kind of hangs around the body for 3 days. So Jesus did it for their understanding that there was no way the spirit could come back and connect to the body. Come on, isn't that amazing what God was doing? God was saying, it's going to be impossible. Hallelujah. They said, could not this man which opened the eyes of him that was blind have caused this man that he should not die? That's his family. His family didn't understand. Sometimes we don't understand why things happen, why we lose our house, why we lose our car. And it's not God doing it to us. But it is God working it out sovereignly for our good. Is this a hopeless situation? Well, Jesus just said this. It's not a hopeless situation. He said, this sickness, somebody say, is not under death. Somebody say, it's not under death. But he said, it's for the glory. Somebody say, it's for the glory of God. So this sickness is not under death, but it's for glory. Whatever you're going through right now, even though you don't understand, it's a lot of things I don't understand. A lot of things I've been through in my life, I never understood. But I went through them with joy and gladness. And I never built my ministry on it. I was just sitting with some folks just by the way, pretty much a couple weeks ago. And I said to them, I don't understand these preachers and these women of God. You know, they build a whole ministry on the bad that was done to them. And they name all the people that did bad to them. I've never ever built my ministry exposing all the bad people did to me. I mean, some people build it on, you know, I was raped by my dad, or you know, my wife left me, and this is what my wife did to me. I've never built, and I would never build a ministry on the bad things people did to me. I just know one thing, that my life is in God's hand, and he's the one that will take my story. I don't have to promote my story. God knows my story, and he knows when it's time, if he wants, to release my story. As long as he knows and the angels know, I'm fine with that. I don't need to promote myself. God knows me. God knows you. Come on, somebody. Are you getting what God is saying tonight? So he said, whatever you're going through, whatever sickness, whatever malady, whatever difficulty, whatever hardship, whatever it may be, it's for the glory of God. Somebody say the glory of God. Because he said the Son of God must be glorified in your life. Some things we don't understand because we cannot pray them away, change them away. I mean, you're looking, some of you are looking at your bodies and your children. All I know is he said, it's not unto death. Somebody say, it's not unto death. But yet, he said, it's not unto death. But yet, he said, the Bible said he let him die. It's not unto death, but he died. It's not unto death. God said, it's not unto death, but I'm dying. I'm losing. I'm failing. I'm trying. But he said, it's not unto death. Later, he looked at them, and he said, Lazarus is dead. Yet he said, the sickness is not unto death. Isn't that amazing? With God, he confuses the mind. He confuses the reason. He freaks the religious. He freaks us out. Lazarus was dead. And Jesus had to walk a long way back because he had run away from the persecution of the religious order. Let me say it again. God does things with prophetic intent. If you're surrendered to God, you have prophetic purpose in everything you're going through. Somebody say, my life matters to God. So then the disciples looked at Jesus and they said, our friend Lazarus has fallen asleep. And they replied, if he's fallen asleep, he will recover. And Jesus said to them, actually, Lazarus is dead. They didn't understand. Jesus knew in his spirit that Lazarus was dead. Let me tell you something. Spiritual folks know when people are spiritually dead. Spiritual folks know where ministries can shout and scream and do whatever they do and have all the music, but they're spiritually dead. I've been to a lot of dead churches. They want you to bring a revival, but they don't want to change. They're dead. There was death. Amen. There was death. There was no life. I mean, a lot of places where there's no life. People of the Spirit know where the life of God is. And that's when you have Jesus. And so we begin to see this background and we see this connection. We see the old. Somebody say the old and the new. See, God's raising up. This is a prophetic word. God is raising up a new seed. The seed is still the same, but it's a new breed. Out of the seed. Amen. It's a new breed out of the seed. It's a new seed out of that breed. Captive to a generation that is caught up in what the Bible said in Romans, a spirit of Sodom and Gomorrah, a spirit of immorality, a spirit of depravity, a spirit of corruption, a spirit of destruction, a spirit that is, the Bible calls Antichrist rebellion. But in that seed, there is a generation that God says, yes, it looks like there's no fire, there's no revival. That's why the Lord said to me this. He said, Benjamin, you don't hype the revival. You don't hype the church. You don't drive it. You allow me to be sovereign. Just preach my word. And you know what? God's going to bring it back to life again. But sometimes, folks, some of those old things have to die. Lazarus had to die. Sometimes those things in your life have to die. Woo! But he said, I will open your graves. He said, I will open your graves and there is a remnant. Somebody say a remnant. See, I believe in South Africa there's a remnant God is raising up. It doesn't mean we're exclusive and, you know, we're the only ones. But I'm going to be honest with you. There's a price to pay. People settle for just the natural. But there's a remnant. Because I'm going to say it again. Why is the world in the mess it is in right now? Because there is no remnant. Well, there is a remnant, but they're hidden, but they haven't manifested. We're in a season where God said to me, there's a manifestation coming.
of his sons and daughters. Are you excited about it? Are you getting what God is saying? We're on Resurrection Sunday, and I'm saying in the mighty name of Jesus, there's a resurrection coming. I could feel it even tonight as we were worshiping the Lord. Life is coming back into the church. God is bringing back his spirit into the church, and it's exciting. Lazarus was wrapped in all this cloth. He was hidden away. But God said, I'm going to resurrect a remnant. Somebody says he's going to resurrect a remnant. There's a resurrection coming that is beginning to raise up. Let me tell you, there was the old, which was the law. There was the old order and the old way of doing things, which was the flesh. But then there were those, the remnant have a heavenly vision. Things are not going well in the natural for the remnant. In fact, the more they serve God, the worse it gets. Seems like everybody else is doing well and you're doing bad. Because you're not leaning on the arm of the flesh. And it's easy, the big test in it all is to go back to what you know. But God doesn't allow you to go back to what you know. Lazarus said, my life, come on, is for the glory of God. That the Son of God may be glorified. My life is for the glory of God. That the Son of God may be glorified. My life is for the glory of God. That the Son of God may be glorified. My situation is for the glory of God. That the Son of God may be glorified. My situation is for the glory of God. That the Son of God may be glorified. So though I may go through this present suffering, amen, it is bringing about, amen, this momentary light affliction is preparing a great weight of God's glory. Oh, hallelujah. There's a glory coming. Amen. And in the midst of South Africa, there's a glory coming. God said to me, you put your foot on South Africa in the spirit and you put your foot on America because there's a glory coming. Hallelujah. Amen. And out of a religious bunch of people that want to stone the spirit of God, that want to stone Jesus, God said, I'm going to raise a fire brand out of the fire. Hallelujah. 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 And praise my name. Somebody say a remnant. A remnant that is going to come back as a heavenly body. And I love the story of Lazarus because it's wrapped up in the old tradition, religion, ideologies, and form, and reason, and culture. And Jesus put Lazarus in a very difficult place. It's literally like putting him, let's say, in Israel right now. If you're Jewish and you go into Palestine, you're going to get killed straight away. Come on, somebody. If you're Jewish and you go in a Muslim area, you're going to get stoned. You're going to get your head cut off. Literally what was happening here was Lazarus was in the most radical terror, if you want to call it, difficult area. Let me tell you what God's doing right now. The revival that's coming, the resurrection that's coming, is going to be revealed and released in some of the most hardest places. Impossible places. Isn't that amazing? The place that they wanted to kill you, stone you, reject you. And Jesus had to go back and Jesus looked to his disciples. He said, let us go into Judea again. Can you imagine what they thought when he said, let us go into Judea again. Let us go into Judea again. Is he mad? They're going to try and stone you there again. Is he mad? How many know it's not always easy following the anointing and anointed men of God? Because you're going to suffer. The godly in Christ will suffer persecution. Hallelujah. Right in the midst of a rejected, dead, buried place where Israel was rejected of God, Israel was buried, God said, I'm going to raise a revival. I'm going to resurrect a people. I'm going to raise up a harvest. Amen. Hallelujah. You know, God could have gone to, he could have gone to Greece. He could have gone to, Jesus could have gone to Rome. He could have gone anywhere. But he said, I'm going to go right there. I'm going to go in the most difficult, hardest place where it caused a death spiritually of my people. And I'm going to bring resurrection. Somebody say resurrection. On this day, and I believe we're trusting God. We're going into Pentecost. We're preparing for Pentecostal fire again. Man, I will pour out my spirit on all flesh, and your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Young men will dream dreams. All men will see visions. And we're coming into that time of glory. The vats shall overflow, amen, with wine and fresh oil. It's time, folks. It's time. I don't care how difficult it is and how many people persecuted you and how many people stoned you and how many difficult situations. And right now, it may have caused your death. You see, what happened is God had rejected the old. But he said, in the midst of the old, I've got a seed. And you cannot destroy the word. Unless a grain of wheat fall into the ground. Come on. And it died, abides alone. But if it dies, God said, I'm going to cause it to rise up again. It's going to rise up again. I am the resurrection and the life. I'm telling you, there's seed in the ground. My spiritual father prayed, and I'm telling you, he spoke so many things, and the devil tried to take him out before his time, but I know that seed's in the ground. There's many men and women of God, their seed is in the ground. But there's a resurrection coming. Glory to God. There's a remnant coming. Hallelujah. In the midst of calamity, in the midst of destruction, there's a remnant. Somebody say, I'm part of the remnant. I'm part of the remnant. And God said, I've rejected the old. But in the midst of that which I've rejected, I'm going to pour out my spirit. They will not even see it. They're going to hate me more for it. They're going to hate you more for it. But I'm going to pour out my spirit. I'm going to reveal my life. I'm going to reveal my power. I'm going to reveal my spirit. And I'm going to reveal something that is new out of the old. Somebody say, glory, hallelujah. So God said, I'm going to raise a remnant that is going to be saved because they're in union with the word of God. Even while they're going into the grave. How many know Lazarus was like, well, the sickness is not unto death. How many know he had a revelation? His sisters panicked. But God said, I'm going to raise up the body. Amen. Hallelujah. The death of the old is coming. In 2005, when I was really at the height of really traveling around in ministry, God said to me, he said, I'm done with the old. He said, Saul is on death row. And he said, I want you to get out of the old. He said, but there's going to come a time when I'm going to call many out of the old system. Hallelujah. Somebody say resurrection. God's going to bring many out of the old. This is where we are right now. And it's difficult for some of you guys to understand it, especially if you've got a lot of church in you. But if you understand spiritually what God is saying now, we're going to see a move of God that is so powerful and mighty. From last week, God spoke about that. He said in that word, he said, the banqueting table is ready. But he said that the invitations are out and people are too busy with their stuff. They're going to miss it. Many will miss it, but there's a resurrection coming. Because they've looked at you and said, oh, you're hopeless. Oh, you never, man, that church ain't never going to go anywhere. They don't do anything. All the prejudgments. But let me tell you something. I'd rather surrender my life and say it's all for the glory of God. I don't mind what you do with my life. I ain't going to hype it up. I'm not going to do anything with it. I'm just going to give it as a living sacrifice unto the Lord. God's going to get glory in that kind of church. Are you with me right now?
Amen. Hallelujah. And he goes in the book of Romans and he begins to deal with Israel in the book of Romans. And you begin to see how he moves from chapter 11 and he goes into chapter 12. And in chapter 12, he speaks about the body of Christ, where he said, there is no Jew, there is no Greek, there is no bond, there is no free, but we all are one man in Jesus Christ. What's God saying? There's a church of the Spirit that he's raising up. The old has been removed. The remnant has been taken out. They're being buried with Christ. Romans chapter 6. They're being raised up into that newness of life together with him. And it's not Jew and it's not Greek, but it's one man and it's of the Spirit. God didn't come and say it's for a blue man or a pink man or a black man or a green man. The gospel is for any man. Hallelujah. And it's for the spirit of man. God took a body that was a flesh body and nobody could recognize that body. Hallelujah. Because the body is to be given. Amen. God's raising up a new man. Hallelujah. So let's go to Lazarus. We look at Lazarus and we begin to see Lazarus in a bad place, like many of us. Are you all good tonight? In a bad place. Amen. I must say this. Jesus doesn't cure your old nature. You still have to get up in the morning and say, goeiemôre, my man. Goeiemôre, my vrou, daar's koffie in die pan. Something like that. You still got to look at that thing. It doesn't go away. It's like one preacher I was with, and I honestly looked at him, and I said this to him. I said, I can see some men can't help looking at men. Some women can't help looking at some men can't help looking at women. We all got an old nature as long as you crucify that nature. That pastor knew exactly what I was saying. We all have an old man. Lazarus was like the old man. And that's the trouble. Amen. We say, Jesus, fix it. Fix this thing. Fix it. We fight it. We shouted it. We try and beat it up. Medicate it. Amen. But the cross of Jesus Christ says, your old man, somebody said, my old man, Romans 6:6, is buried. Somebody say, it's buried. My old man is buried. It's dead. Somebody say, it's dead. True revival is going to come when we have this revelation of laying our lives down. Folks, even there's many businessmen here. You're still in control. Husbands, wives, you're still in control. Real revival that is going to come forth is going to be a generation that is corporately connected because they've died to everything that they were, and they're living in the resurrection and the life of the body in heavenly places. Hallelujah. Somebody say, I'm crucified with him. So Jesus never came to any old man and didn't say, I'm going to heal that old man. I'm going to fix that old man. I'm going to sort that old man. I'm going to make that old man better. Like many preachers say, better you. Well, there ain't no better you. Amen. They try to see a cure for Lazarus, but there was no cure for Lazarus's sicknesses. And there's no cure for the old man. The old man will just keep on committing the same sins all the time. Amen. So you may have a body that's infirm. You may have situations in your body. You may have, you know, depression, whatever it may be with yourself, in yourself, going through your troubles.
You may love the Lord. But when we see the grace of Jesus Christ, are you with me today? The grace of Jesus Christ doesn't remove that nature. It helps you. But there's a realm beyond grace, folks. A lot of preachers preaching grace today. But there's a realm beyond grace. And you know what that says? Philippians chapter 3:12. Not that I. Amen. Not that I am already made perfect. I'm not already made perfect. You know, grace can do miracles and can help you. But you're still going to be disappointed in yourself, in your old nature. But there's the real side of the gospel. And the real gospel of Jesus Christ is not just grace every day. It's resurrection power. Because when you die, the seed will come out of the ground. And resurrection power. Amen. Resurrection power can still be there while your body's sick. Oh, you don't understand what I'm saying. Resurrection power can still be there when you're still battling with your own fleshly nature. You have a choice. You say, okay, I'm going to walk in the grace or I'm going to walk in the power. I'm going to walk in the grace or I'm going to walk in the power. Revival is the power. Grace is there when you're just kind of like going through, but you go to the point it takes you to, grace takes you to death. Death then brings you to power. Stuff still is the same, but it's not the same. Because you're living in the power of resurrection. Amen. Resurrection covers everything. Amen. The Bible said we must know Him, the fellowship of His sufferings and the power. Somebody said the power. So are you weak physically? You're struggling physically. But Paul said it this way, 2 Corinthians 12:10, when I am weak, then am I strong. What is the power? The power was overcoming the weakness in the power of resurrection. Amen. For the glory of God. See, you got to give it to Him and say, I surrender it to you. I'm not fighting it. I'm not gracing it. I'm sowing it. And you're going to raise it. Amen. 2 Corinthians 12:9 said, most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my weaknesses. That the power, somebody said the power, of Christ may rest upon me. Folks, this is good for your spirit. You say, this church, you're going to get some stuff in you. Take it in you. This is good for you. This is good on this resurrection Sunday. He was speaking. He was in infirmity. He was in weakness. He was in suffering. People don't talk about this stuff. But he had power. We're going to see the real revival. We are not going to be moved by what our experience is now. In the physical realm. Amen. If we live in the self life, we're not going to make it. We're going to give up. We're going to throw in the towel. If we look at our infirmities, if we look at our weaknesses, if we look at our troubles, if we look at our infirmities, we're going to give up. But if we give up, we're going to lose the greatest blessing, the greatest victory that has been given to us. And His name is Jesus. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. My grandmother always used to say this. Jésus, tu es le chemin, la vérité et la vie. She was a French woman. All when she was in her 80s, that's all she said every day. Jésus, tu es le chemin, la vérité et la vie. Every day, she loved to say that. Amen. She was an amazing woman. I tell you, even when she lost her mind, she could really dress, that's for sure. Oh, she would look and say, oh, that looked very good on you, did very nice, you know. Amen. The Apostle Paul is a great role model of suffering. And I'm not saying we look for suffering, but this body is full of suffering. Amen. He went through adversities. He went through difficulties. The Bible said he went through nakedness. He went through being lost at sea. But he said this, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I can do all things because I have power to overcome. While this outward man is perishing, the inward man is being renewed daily. Life is flowing in me. He said in 2 Corinthians 1:9, we ourselves have had the sentence of death within ourselves, that we should not trust in ourselves, but in God, which raises the dead. Somebody say, raises the dead. So again, we look at Lazarus and we see hopelessness, helplessness. I don't know what you're going through right now, but I know what God says. If you're listening tonight, I know what God says. Nothing could be done in the natural. But the Bible said, I'm going to get glory out of it. I'm going to get glory out of it. Amen, folks. The glory of God is manifested in those, like Abraham said it, I'm as good as dead. When all hope was gone, he hoped against hope while he was as good as dead. While he's as good as dead, God brought the victory. Are you with me today? As good as dead, God brought the resurrection and God brought the life. So he said the sickness. Somebody said the sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God. God was glorified in the resurrection. And the glory of God is in the death, there is a resurrection. If you're willing to let go. If you're willing to give over. I don't know what you're fighting. I don't know what you're struggling with. I don't know what difficulty you're going through. I don't know what hurt you're going through. I don't know what pain you're going through. I don't know what fight you're going through. But I love the story of Lazarus, which is almost a preparation of the life of Jesus in some form. Because Jesus willingly gave up his life as a seed. Lazarus gave up his life to reveal the resurrection power of Jesus Christ. Amen. I believe we're coming into that, folks. Amen. The resurrection power of Jesus Christ is here. Amen. We're in this time of 577. I'm nearly finished, folks. And 77 is literally perfection and completion. We must lay hold. Somebody say, lay hold. How do we lay hold? We lay down the old. We say, Lord, great is he that's in me than he that's in the world. In this new millennium and in this time, we are moving into what has been established when Jesus said it is finished. Even though he was going through that, he knew it was finished. He's the end, he's the beginning, and it is finished. The devil is lost. The outward man looked dead. Jesus took time. But God said in the midst, I'm raising the people. Somebody said, I'm part of that people. Somebody said, we take the victory. So while you experience whatever you experience by faith, you seize it. Because you know what Lazarus did? He stepped into the future. And he brought it in right now. Somebody said, I'm somewhere in the future. I look much better than I look right now. Outward man was perishing. Things were looking impossible. Come on, South Africa, in the flesh, everybody's negative. Everybody's speaking death. Everybody's saying it's hopeless. But somebody say, I'm in the future, and I'm bringing it into the now. Somebody say, there's no hope for the church. Somebody said the world is going, people say the world is going into destruction. But I tell you something, whatever we're going through is for the glory of God. Somebody say, well, Christianity is losing its way in the Middle East. Well, we say God's going to raise up a remnant in the Middle East. God's going to raise up a remnant in South Africa. God's going to raise up a remnant in Africa. God's going to raise up remnants in China. God's going to raise them up in the United States. God's going to raise them up in South America. God's going to raise it up in this hour. We're in the year 5777. It's prophetic because there's never been a year 5777. And it's the year of the sword and the year of divide. And God's cutting off the old. He's releasing perfection in the new. Amen. And the Bible said, if you endure to the end, you shall be saved. Amen. Somebody say power. He leaned on God. He trusted in his word. And God said, I'm releasing my resurrection power. 777 means approval, completion. God's approval, God's completion. God's perfection, God's establishment of his kingdom. Christ in you, the hope of glory. We shall see it in the season now. The old natures are suffering, but God's bringing a death. How many felt that tonight? Presence of God. The glory of God. Taking it to the cross. Taking the old nature to the cross. Laying it down at the cross. Walking in resurrection power. Seeing Satan, like Jesus said, fall like lightning from heaven. Man, he's playing some stuff. He said in the last days, he said, I saw the dragon breathing. But God raised up a glorious church. And they chucked him out of his place of domain and authority. And that's at the cross. He fell. Just like Lazarus. God gave me a word. And there's much I can say tonight. I'm just going to close with this because there was a lot that was said, which was good. I remember I was in my spiritual father's home in 2000. And I was sitting there after going through a lot of things where God sent me to South Africa from the United States. And I was just about to take, and I was about to leave there, and I was sitting in on the couch just like this, and we were just praying, and I was just sitting down, and I began to look, and my eyes didn't see the floor anymore. I couldn't see anything but what was in the spirit. And I began to look, and I saw a valley filled with dead bones. Not dead bones, it was dead bodies. All these dead bodies on the floor. And the Lord, you know, told me to get up, and I was in this vision while I was there. And I began to walk slowly into this deathly place. And I saw an old man. The Lord looked at me and he said, I want you to tell him to get up. And I said, get up. And the Lord said, you say it with greater power. I said, get up. He said, now I want you to say it with power. I said, get up. Like that. I don't want to scare anybody. But life came back into him. And I saw that same man. God began to release life through him to release life to others. You see, there's resurrection power coming. Prophetic resurrection coming. Many have been through so many experiences negatively. They don't have faith in God anymore. They're lying there, doing everything, but experiencing nothing anymore. But there's resurrection here tonight. I want everybody to stand up. I am the resurrection and I am the life. And we're going to close, if people listening, we're going to close tonight. And I want you to see Jesus. He said, on the third day, I will arise. On the third day, I will arise. I want you to see the seed, the promised seed of Jesus. You know, I had a vision of God. This is a very powerful vision. And in this vision, I was on national television. And I said on national television, if every believer around the world would lay down their lives at the same time, there will be such an explosion of God's power and God's glory. Are you with me? The outward man lays down there, but the inward man. There must be a dying. Oh, hallelujah. Grace helps you, but resurrection power takes you. Hallelujah. Come on, lift up your hands again to the Lord. Pray in the Spirit right now. Kores. Moshikatam Montolo, if you're listening at home, you pray in the Spirit right now. I'm going to believe for the resurrection power of Jesus Christ. The resurrection power of Jesus Christ. That tonight is a turning point. I was praying for tonight's service, and there was only one scripture God gave me. He said, I'll restore the hearts of the fathers to the son, and the sons to the father. What he's literally saying is, I'm bringing a resurrection of my image. My glory shall be seen in the earth through my sons. Violence shall turn away in South Africa. Again, I saw on national television in this vision that as I spoke this word, if we could all lay our lives down at the same time, such a glory, such a power, such miracles. Maybe you've been trying things in your own strength, trying to deal with yourself, deal with your hurts, deal with your pains. But there's a life we must take, and his name is Jesus. Come on, just pray with some fire right now. Brotus to Kumuraman and Brenda Belebetam Blocos Ticante and Brena Mostama Misco Promata Bremetin Crindo Tosti Crenda Nonomonta Remedetesta Miconcina Mandol Panesco Pramine Killa Bonomoton Delebede. Let healing come, life come, let hope come. Kinemeto Lobobros Ticoromonda La Banama, completion, perfection. Cremen Amanda, we step into the future and take that life. It's ours, it's our inheritance. Restore right now. Restore right now. Restore, 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 restore. Restore, restore, restore. Resurrect, 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 resurrection. Resurrection life. I am the way, the truth. I am the life. I am the life. I am the life. I am the life. 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 Every point, every plan of the enemy to bring death, spiritual death, depravity, destruction. In the midst of a Sodom and Gomorrah world, there's a seed that rises up. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I hear the voice of the Lord saying, even in California, the Lord would say there's a seed, a remnant rising. In California, says the Lord, I'm raising up a seed, a remnant. It shall stand and release my glory in the earth, and they shall see it. They shall know, the Lord would say, even in this house shall have a part. Oh, hallelujah. Am I raising up a remnant, says God, even now. Many speak doom and gloom over Los Angeles and over that place, says God. But I'm going to have mercy and grace, says the Lord. I'm turning things around. I'm turning things around, says God. Turning things for your good and for your favor. Resurrection and life.
I am the resurrection. I am the resurrection. I am the life. I'm the resurrection. I'm the life. The way you're going to tap into it, folks, is to lay down your life. Somebody said, Lord, tonight I lay down my life. On this very special day that you lay down your life, I lay down my life. The old man. I'm not going to try and change him. I'm going to crucify him. I'm burying that old man, that old woman, that old nature. It's not part of me. And right now, I lift up both hands again and just breathe in. So I breathe in your life. The same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead dwells in me, and it'll quicken this mortal body. Now breathe it in again. There it is. I breathe in your life. I breathe in your healing. I breathe in your resurrection power. I refuse to do it in my strength. When I am weak, you're strong. I'm walking in power. I'm walking in favor. I'm walking in miracles. I am a child of God. I want to say this, folks. Jesus had a human flesh, but he lived with the Spirit. Oh, you say, but that's Jesus. Well, he said the same Spirit. I think he had the worst old nature ever. Come on. All you religious folk are looking at me. I think he had the worst desires ever. But he had a revelation. He was the Son of God, yes. But he didn't do it in himself. He did it in the power of the Holy Spirit. And he said, that same Spirit, when I'm gone, I'm going to give it to you. So take it. Put it on. Put on Christ. You can do it. Because if I did it, you can do it. But you've got to go through the cross and move into the resurrection. Somebody say, resurrection power. I pray for a minute in fire. Come on, just pray with fire. It's just good. Just take it with fire, the Holy Ghost. If you're at home, just take it. Take it with fire. Take it with fire. Hallelujah. My empowering anointing, and strength is coming to you. Strength is coming to your weakness, to your weaknesses. Strength, strengthening your being, strengthening your bodies, strengthening in your weakness, empowering you in your failures, causing you to rise above, causing you to take to flight, causing you to soar above, causing you to bring glory to my name. Oh, so you shall go from this place with great praise on your lips. So you shall go from this place with great victory in your heart. So you shall go from this place with great joy, says the Lord your God. For you will begin to see the embers of the fire that I have begun to start. I begin to cause the flicker of the flame of my spirit to burn within your hearts. Oh, hallelujah. And it shall be contagious. Oh, it shall begin to reach out beyond even the circumference of that which you even are comfortable with. For the Lord would say, I'm getting ready to visit this house, and households shall be saved. Households shall be changed. For this is the beginning of a new beginning, says the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And out of the grave a seed shall rise. Out of that root it shall be the root of Jesse, giving glory to my name. Hallelujah. Give him praise. 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 Some have sought silver. Some have sought gold. But they never realized the true wealth that I have. Surely it shall rise, and men shall hear of it, and the fame shall spread of it, as was the wisdom of Solomon, so shall the wisdom of my people that shall bring glory to my name. Hallelujah. Isn't God good? Isn't God good? How many love him? It's like God is so here. The only thing you can do is just take him. There's nothing more you can do. Just step into it. God's going to do the healing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's a hopelessness, something going on there, like a hopelessness. There's a hopelessness that God's about to turn around, just like what the Lord said about Lazarus. He's reaching out, and that young lady, oh, praise God, the touch of God is coming upon you. From this night onwards, you shall never be the same. And even that woman has been, there's things that accessed your life that shouldn't have accessed. But God is closing the door from this night onwards. And that spirit that tries to torment you shall no longer. Come on, give him praise. Just come here, Teresa. How many of we serve a miracle working God? Resurrection power is here tonight, so you just take it, the healing. That's power. Resurrection power. Just don't turn back. Just go forward. Go forward in him. In Jesus' name. Praise God. Somebody say, I'm getting ready for revival. It's just like the Holy Spirit takes me here. And it's like, yep, we're about to step over, but it's like he's building up. How many feel that? It's building. It's building. It's going to be sovereign. Isn't that beautiful? I love Brother Hagin. I grew up on Brother Hagin as a young child. Brother Hagin would minister sometimes 3 weeks to 6 weeks every night. 3 weeks, 4 weeks, 5 weeks, nothing would happen. But on the fifth week, the 6 weeks, the presence and the power of God would just take over. Let me tell you something, we're getting ready for that, people. But we're building in the Spirit from glory to glory. Let's give God a clap of praise tonight. It's sweet. Things are shifting. If there's anybody whose every head is bowed and eyes closed, you don't know Jesus as your Savior. You heard this word. You say, I'm spiritually dead. The Bible said that Jesus came to seek and save those that were lost. Jesus came to give you life, life more abundantly. His life is in his nature. It's through his Spirit. He said it's appointed for man once to die, and then the judgment. All must face that seat of judgment. If you want to make Jesus Lord of your life tonight, I give you this opportunity. As every head is bowed and eyes closed, would you raise your hand? Anybody in this house? You say, I want to make Jesus Lord of my life. Anybody? Anybody?
Anybody? Praise God. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Is anybody else? You say, I'm lost, or you're backslidden. Maybe you've run away from God. Why don't you run to God? Hallelujah. There's somebody over there. Put their hand up. Praise God. If you're that person that raised your hand, just come to the front real quick. Praise God. I'm going to pray with you. Oh, yes, and all to thee. Anybody? My precious Savior, I surrender, surrender all. Hallelujah. And I surrender. Just to say after me, tonight is a fresh night for you. Say, Lord Jesus, thank you that you died for me on Calvary's cross. I make a decision today, the day that you rose from the grave and you took the keys of death, hell, and the grave. I receive you tonight as my Lord and as my Savior. I repent of my sins. I ask you to wash me and cleanse me with your blood. And thank you that tonight I am born again. For I believe with my heart and I confess with my mouth. Seal me unto the day of salvation. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father God. Amen. You've had a lot of negative words spoken over your life. Experienced a lot of things, caused you to go down some roads that many people didn't necessarily take. But God's, I see you came tonight, and there's a lot of ability, a lot of talent, and a lot of creativity that God's going to stir up inside of you. And you're a firebrand plucked out of the fire that God's going to use for His glory. A lot of things going to come off of you quickly. A lot of chains are breaking even right now. That thing that tries to visit you and torment you shall no longer. For the Lord would say, my peace shall come upon thee. And you shall know what grace is. Mercy and grace has prevailed over judgment. The Lord would say, I've saved thee and healed thee. And from this night onward, said God, what you did tonight was not just an emotional decision. It was a decision that you say, I want to see if this is real. You shall experience the reality of who I am. I shall use you to touch the lives of many, to speak hope to many, and to deliver many, says the Lord God. For this is a fresh new start in your life. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Amen. Thank you, Father. He's made a decision. And I cancel every assignment of the enemy. I cancel every assignment of darkness, every spirit of destruction. Every bad person, negative person in his life, release him from it in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father God, that you will be his Father. That, Lord, he's longed for instruction and direction. He shall receive it. Shield her and cover her in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you, Father. Use her. That today's a day of restoration. In Jesus' name, I cancel every assignment of the enemy, every spirit of hell, every force of darkness, cut it off in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's give God a praise tonight. In Jesus' name.